Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to another broadcast on the organ from Hope Lutheran Church in Bozeman. I'm Matthew O'Sullivan. I'm really excited to play for you again. Today, I've chosen four pieces to play. What they all have in common is that they're all by French composers. Two of them are shorter, kind of interlude type pieces, and two are much more substantial. I'm going to start with a piece by Jean Langlais, one of the major 20th century French organists. It's a movement from his suite Mediévale. The piece is called Tiento. I'm going to move now to the music of Camille Saint-Saëns. And this piece was not actually originally written for the organ. It's an arrangement of the slow movement of Saint-Saëns' Organ Symphony, but those of you who know that will know that it's a piece for orchestra where the organ is a big and prominent part of it. The famous American organist Virgil Fox, who did so much to popularize the organ to audiences during the mid-20th century, arranged this piece, which is the slow movement of the organ symphony, for organ solo.
Thank you.
I'm going to turn now to the music of another great 20th century organist, Maurice Duruflé. Duruflé, although he lived a long life, only published 14 pieces during his lifetime because he was very, very fastidious about what he published. This little piece called Meditation, which he wrote in 1964, wasn't actually among them. It appears to have been published after his death. And finally, I'm going to turn to the music of César Franck, the composer who possibly more than anyone else helped to found the great French organ school in the 19th century. He was renowned as an improviser and a teacher, and he left wonderful organ works as well. Only a very few of them, but really substantial. This piece is the third chorale in A minor, which Franck wrote in the last year of his life in 1890. You'll hear that it starts with some very, very busy figuration and quite dramatic, and then in the middle there's a glorious reed melody which goes on for some time before the initial very, very busy figuration returns and there's a grand ending.